Hello students. So in last lecture, till our last lecture, we have finished about the reflection, like what actually reflection is, and incident ray, and you know all these angles we have discussed. Now we will talk about the types of reflection. All right. So we'll be discussing about the types of reflection. Now children, there can be two types of reflection, regular reflection and irregular reflection, right? So we will be discussing now about the regular reflection and irregular reflection. Right now, regular reflection and irregular reflection. What is, see, I'm not discussing over here about the reflection, like what reflection is, because we have already discussed about like what reflection means and what is like how, like, you know, different ways of definitions and all we have discussed. So now, what is the meaning of regular reflection? See children, the regular reflection occurs from which kind of place? First of all, from where it takes place. So first of all, we'll talk about regular reflection takes place from which kind of surface. So it will always takes place from the very smooth surface, okay, smooth surface, or I should say highly polished, okay, highly polished surface, and where we can find these kind of substances. So the examples can be like, we can talk about the mirror itself, then we can even give the example of polished, highly polished wood. So polished wood, and even still water. Still water, that means the water when it is not moving. So what actually happens in reflection, regular reflection? Now see, this is our plane mirror. I'll not talk about plane mirror, I'll talk about reflecting, very smooth reflecting surface, because in this way we will be discussing about the all the surfaces. Now this is the polished surface, right? This is the polished surface and this is the reflecting surface. Now what is the difference between these two? Like here, this side the images cannot be formed because it is polished, it is packed. Now here this side is open, and whenever the light will fall on this, it is going to come back, it will be turning back. So this is the reflecting surface. Now this is the now what will happen? Now suppose when the ray of light, or I should say beam of rays, when it falls, when it falls on this reflecting surface, so what happens? It is like, I won't be labeling all these beams. See, actually, whenever we talk about the reflection, and whenever the certain amount of light is falling on some object, and whenever we'll be talking about drawings, our making of formation of images over here, we'll not be taking many more rays. When we'll be discussing about the rays, like we'll be taking only two rays, right? Why two rays? Or else it will become very difficult to understand if we take many rays altogether, right? Now here, when I say like the, so what will happen? It will reflect back. So again, if these rays are falling, it is going to reflect back. Now one very important thing which is there in this, like arrows has to be maintained so that we can understand from where what which ray is coming, right? Now see, now what is, now this can be labeled as mm dash. Now see, what actually is happening in regular reflection, children? Now here, when the beam of rays, okay, when this falls on this reflecting surface, these are actually, they are parallel to each other. When they are falling, they are parallel to each other, and their incidence angles, all the incident angle are equal. And what happens? Definitely after falling on this reflecting surface, it is going to, all these rays will be reflecting back. So when this reflect back, children, even after reflection, these rays comes in a parallel way, and that too in a particular direction. This is very important point to be noted. Like what? When this parallel rays, it get reflected, these rays get reflected in the parallel way only, and that too also facing in a one particular direction. And that is the reason, you know, the image formation takes place. Okay, that is the reason the image formation takes place. Image formation takes place. Now, if you have observed yourself any time in the still water also, still water in the sense when water is not moving, it's not flowing, it is just still, it's calm. And when you try to look, when you try to see yourself in water, you might have observed that you will be able to see your image. Why? Because even the still water is capable of reflecting the light very, very properly in one particular direction only, and so we will be able to see our image. Same is happening along with the highly polished surfaces also. If you talk about very smooth surfaces, the wooden the wooden furnitures which are very highly polished and shiny surfaces, so you will be able to see this. And you know, actually what is there at this plane surface, why this plane surface, smooth surface is required? Because whenever these surfaces are smooth, the particles are arranged in one particular way. Particles are arranged in one particular way. That means they are not spread haphazardly, right? They all are arranged very, very properly. That means in any smooth surface, plane surface, all these particles are arranged, very smoothly, nicely, properly they are arranged. That is the reason when the beam of ray falls on this, this reflecting surface, it get reflected. But again, what is more important to understand, that these rays will be reflected in a particular direction only, and that too in a parallel way. Now, if we talk about the naming, we can name all these, isn't it? Like we can name all these rays, but that's up to you. But one main thing I will be writing over here, that these are incident rays, these are reflected rays, alright. And here, as the incident angle is all equal, that is the reason angle of reflection is also equal. Now, when we talk about irregular reflection can also be known as, children, diffuse reflection. It can be also known as diffuse reflection. Now, what is this diffuse reflection? So first of all, it takes place from irregular or rough surface. It takes place from the irregular or rough surface. Now, this is the rough surface. Now, definitely when we talk about the rough surface, the particles are not arranged in any particular way. So, particles are not arranged. Particles are not arranged in a particular direction. Okay, the particles are not arranged. These all particles are haphazardly set in any direction. Now, what happens over here when this beam of rays falls on this uneven surface? So what happens, actually, they get scattered. They get scattered in any direction. They get scattered unevenly. They get spread unevenly in any of the direction. Right? So you can see over here, when this comes, even when this comes, it can go anywhere in any direction. Even I can draw one more to make you understand more properly. Right? So, now, what is the problem over here? First of all, the surface is not smooth, right? and all the parallel beams which are falling on this irregular surface, the incident angles are not equal. When the incident angles are not equal, definitely the reflection, the angle of reflection will also will not be equal. Now, you know children, here you take an example of anything which you can see around you, the, you know, the board. Chalk, anything, you know, your boxes, any box, then your cups, anything which you can see. Actually, you know, here we said like image formation takes place, and here we are saying that image formation do not takes place because when these rays, incident rays, when these fall on the reflecting surface, they do not move in one particular direction. They do not move in one particular direction, they will even go likewise here. They all are moving haphazardly in uneven way in all different directions. You know children, this is the reason why we are able to see the things, okay. This is the reason why we are able to see the objects, able to see the different objects. Actually, what all things are present around us, near us, are 99% rough, okay. They all are rough, and so they undergo, they show diffuse kind of reflection, they show irregular reflection. That means the light when it falls on it, these kind of substances, objects, so they scatter the light, they scatter the light in all different directions, and that is the reason we are able to see all these objects. Are you clear? Right? So, irregular reflection is very, very important because of the irregular reflection only we will be able to see all these different kind of objects. So, just now what we have studied about the types of reflection. So, regular reflection and irregular reflection. Now, regular reflection is what? Regular reflection is a reflection where the, when this rays fall parallelly on the reflecting surface, it get reflected in the parallel way in one direction only, they get reflected, okay. The reflection takes place in one particular direction only, in one particular direction only. But here what is happening? Here the reflected ray gets scattered. Reflected ray gets scattered. Right? So here what is happening? The surface, here surface is very smooth. Here surface is not smooth, irregular. Here the particles are arranged in a particular way. Particles are not arranged in a particular way. Then all the incident rays are equal, and that is the reason our angle of reflections are also equal. Here incident rays are not equal, and so even reflection, the angle of reflection are not equal. Here the image formation takes place. Here the object, we are able to see the objects because the light gets scattered, you know, the lights get scattered in all different directions, right. So this is how we can, you know, distinguish between the this regular reflection and irregular reflection, right. Now, whenever we talk about this regular and irregular reflection, you know, best example can be taken, you know, of the cinema hall, right, of the cinema hall. You know, when the, with the help of the projector, when the light is allowed to fall on the screen, it gets scattered, from there it gets scattered in all different directions, and that is the reason we are able to see the movie, right. So now after this we will be talking about the objects and images, what actually, here I am talking about the image, but what actually image is, what actually object is. So we will continue with this, just I will clean up the board. Now what are objects? What is the meaning of object? So anything which gives out light either its own or may be reflected. Is called as object. Now see, what is the meaning of this definition? Anything which gives out light. See, we are able to see any object because either it emits own light, isn't it? If you talk about sun, if you talk about sun emits its own light, isn't it? Sun emits its own light. Sun is a star and it emits its own light. Along with sun, certain fish and certain the fireflies and all insects. That means even if you talk about the tube lights, bulbs, LED, these all objects and organism emit their own light. That is the reason we are able to see them. Now, sun, fish, then few insects, then if you talk about tube lights. So why we are able to see them, see these all objects? Because they emit light. They emit light. But then why we are able to see all different objects? Any object, like you talk about book, tree, duster, anything, because they reflect light, right? They reflect light. This we have already discussed in the very first part of this chapter. So these all comes under the category of object. That means anything, any object is what, how we can say object in terms of physics. So anything which is emitting its own light, right? Or due to some source of light, light is falling on that object and then that light is being reflected by that particular object. So anything which gives out light, either its own light or reflected light, is known as object. Now this object can be of various size. It can be very small, right? It can be very small object and it can be very large object. So small object is known as point object. Small object is known as point object, and its image is like when we will be making these all diagrams, how it will be, how we are going to show this very small object with the help of a dot. So dot is utilized, a dot will be utilized to understand this this object is very small. Okay, so see, what is object? Anything which emits its own light or the light is being reflected by that particular substance will be object according to the physics. Now this object can be of very small size. If it is of very small size, then it is known as point object. And on now we'll be drawing all the various kinds of ray diagrams. So in these ray diagrams, this object plays very important role. All the ray diagrams which we'll be discussing, which we'll be drawing, which we'll be practicing over here, either we'll be taking little bigger object, small object, even sometimes many a times point object, right? So here, how to denote, how to draw this objects in the ray diagram? So it will be denoted with the help of the only dot, right? Now if the object is large, then it is known as extended object. It is known as extended object, and it is denoted by an arrow like this. It is denoted by an arrow on which this part, like this arrow part, it is always towards the upper side. Now so this is the way to denote the extended object. Now this object, whenever these different kinds of objects are kept, seen, so what will happen? Their image formation takes place. What will happen? Definitely when the object is kept and this all detailing you will be able to understand just now when after some time we will be discussing the diagrams. So what will happen? The image formation will also takes place. Now what is the meaning of the image? Very important point. how to define image, right? So image is an, image is an, now what I am doing, see here I have defined object and now here I am trying to define the image. So image is an optical appearance right produced when light rays coming from an object are reflected from a mirror or even refracted through lens. So this lens part we will understand afterwards, right? So now what image is actually? So children, image is when, you know, it is formed whenever the rays actually they meet or they appears to meet. So when image is formed, children, image will be formed when the rays will appear to meet or they meet, right? So what actually image is, it is an optical appearance produced when light rays coming from an object are reflected from a mirror, right? So when the, this is the object, from here the light ray is, you know, a light ray get, you know, it falls on this point and it gets reflected, at this time the image formation will takes place. Now, we'll talk about two different types of images, children. The images can be of two different types. I can write this also like now real image and virtual image. See, in the beginning it will appear that you are not able to understand anything, but then till the point, you know, we have, you know, after completing all this thing, like after completing this particular lecture, you will be able to understand what real and virtual image is, right? So now real image is the image which actually forms, Virtual image is an image which appears to, like, you know, here the light rays do not actually meet. So I'll just write this difference, these differences, and then we will draw the diagram and then we will be able to understand properly, right? Or even we can draw the diagram first. This is the, I am taking the plane mirror now, right? Now this is the plane mirror, this is the reflecting surface. Now this is the O point, and O point is just like a dot, very small, that means a dot object is being taken, right? What is being taken? This is the object which is being denoted by O, and this is a very small object, right? Now the light from, you know, the object reflects the light, and this light is OA which falls on the point A. O is a point object, very small object. From this object the light ray travels, which light ray? OA, which falls on the point A, and this get reflected, right? And this get reflected. Now if this is the normal, we have discussed all this normal and all in the previous lecture. So this is incident angle I1 and this is the reflected angle R1, right? Now again we'll take one more light. This A is, you know, it get reflected, and this is the point X, right? So OA is an incident ray which get reflected in the form of the AX. In this angle, I1 is the incident angle and R1 is the reflected angle, right? Now again one more ray of light travels, and it travels like this, and this is O, this is A, and here I can denote it with the B. You can denote you know, you can change, you can denote as you want, as you feel comfortable, right? So now this is the ray which is again traveling from the point O, like object O. So OB is an incident ray which is incident, you know, falling on which point, which is falling on point B, and from here it is again getting reflected, and it is getting reflected at this point Y, right? So now if somebody, you know, like here, if you want to see this point from here, so what will happen now? This, if I, E is here, okay? So actually I'll tell you something. Now, you know, this is a point object, an image will be formed over here somewhere, and this will be denoted, I'll be denoting it with the help of I. Now listen to me very carefully. Actually here no image formation takes place. You know, if I try to right, if I try to you know, okay, now can you see these two rays? Will this meet at any point? No, these two are diverging. Diverging means they both are moving apart from each other. They both are moving far from each other. And if they are moving, see, if they are moving far, so how these two rays will be meeting? For meeting, what should be there? They should converge, they should meet, they should come along at one point. So there is no meeting point, and hence no image formation, really no image formation takes place. Now, if we try to extend this rays at the back side, this in reality will not happen, right? So this, if I try to extend it at the back side, right, this I'm extending at the back side. So what is happening here? See, here at point I, the image formation takes place. So I hope now you'll be able to understand, for the formation of an image, for when the image will be formed, when the light rays meet. But here also the light rays are actually not meeting. These light rays are not actually meeting. And when the person sees from here, EI, when the person is seeing from here, this person will not be able to understand that these rays are coming from this way. So what this person will understand, that these rays are coming from this side. So when the image is formed by, you know, like, you know, the image is not formed, you know, cannot be formed on screen. That means if you keep a screen over here, you won't be able to get screen, because this is a plane mirror. You cannot keep the screen at the back side, isn't it? So the these light rays cannot go at the back side, because plane mirror is already painted. There is a silver coating on the you know, this mirror. So what actually, again we'll discuss this, children, this M dash is the reflecting surface, okay? This one, from this side it is polished, right? From this side it is polished, right? And this side, left hand side, is the reflecting surface. Now O object is kept over here. This O object is very minute object, very small object, and that is the reason it is known as what? Point object. It is known as what? Point object. Now from this point the ray of light travels, which first of all we have discussed OA. It is very important to, you know, to make the arrows so that we can understand that which ray is going where, which side. So this, with the help of arrow, we can understand that this, from object O, the ray of light travels, OA, the light ray OA travels to the point A, and it gets reflected back at point X. So AX is a reflected ray, right? OA is an incident ray. So incident ray, incident ray is what, children? OA, right? And the here the second incident ray is what? OB, right? So incident ray is OA and OB, right? And reflected rays are, so OA will get reflected, this OA will get reflected as AX, and this OB will get reflected as by, right? So it will be by. So, and here again I can make a normal, right? This will be angle I2 and R2. That means the incident angle 2 and the reflected angle 2. So here actually there is no meeting of rays, and so real image is not formed. This, when extended at the back, the image is formed, which is known as virtual image. That means it is actually not forming, it appears to be formed, isn't it? So now if I want to write the difference between the real image and the virtual image, see, here we have taken one example of point object. Now I will take one other, another example where I'll be trying to explain this with the help of the extended object, right? So let's see that example where I'll be taking the extended object. But as there's little, you know, a little place over here, I won't be able to draw. So now we're discussing about the, first of all, the real and virtual, real image and virtual image. Right? So first of all, what is real image? It actually forms on the screen, right? Can be formed on the screen. Real image can be formed on the screen. This is not a real image, this is virtual image. Which image is formed over here? Here virtual image is formed. Virtual image, where the rays of light do not actually meet, they just appear to meet, right? And virtual image is what? Cannot be, can't be formed on the screen. Right? Now, this image, real image, is always inverted. It is always inverted. Now, what is the meaning of inverted? See, if suppose this is the image, right? This is the image, object, and this is the image. So, like, it is inverted. This kind of image will be known as inverted image. Now, object will always be, suppose I'm denoting this object as AB. Now, image of the object will be denoted by what? Like A dash, B dash. Like here only we have, like it will be same only, but then we have to write dash, we have to put dash, so that we can understand the difference between the image and the object, or else how we will be able to understand like which one is the object and which one is the image. So, AB is the, you know what, it is the object. So here we have to mention it, we will always put dash over here so that we can understand like whether this is image or object. Right? Now here, so it is always inverted, real image. Here we have seen the example of the point object, so we are not able to see the inverted image. In the second example, when I will be drawing the diagram, there we will be able to see that how inverted images are formed. Right? So here the which kind of real image, like what is real image? It is image which really, where the rays meet. Here the rays are not meeting, so this is the virtual image. Now it is always inverted. This is erect. Okay, erect means what? As like when we see ourselves, in the mirror, we see as it, as we are standing, isn't it? We do not see us as, you know, head at the bottom and the legs up. We do not see us in this way, upside down. So it is erect, but it is laterally inverted. Laterally inverted. Now, what is the meaning of laterally inverted, children? This, after explaining this, we will be discussing about the lateral inversion. So now I'm not talking about this, right? Now, here this will be okay. Here the rays actually meet. Rays after reflection actually meet. Here rays after reflection just appears to meet. Just appears to meet, right? And real images, you know, are always mentioned. They are drawn with a, you know, direct continuous line. Okay, and they are represented by dotted line. As you all can see here, I have made certain dotted lines because the virtual image formation has taken place. So whenever we will try to try to meet the rays, okay. So here we have done this with the help of the dot, because actually it is not happening. We are trying, like, you know, actually the person who will be seeing this image from here, it will appear that these rays are coming from this side and not from this side, right? So this is the difference between the real image and the virtual image. Now we'll, here in this example, we have taken the example of the point object, right? Here we have taken the example of the point object, and now just on this side I'll be again making a diagram where I'll be taking an example of the extended object, right? So please note this, and again we'll revise.